So I just saw this question on the 1% Club Instagram page. Let's take a look. Given that 0 plus 100 is 100, 1 plus 99 is 100, 2 plus 98 is 100, the question is, what is the sum of all the whole numbers between 0 and 100? In fact, this is a very, very classic math question. It was first solved by Gauss. So let's take a look. Essentially, we're just trying to do this 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus da 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 up to 100. So how do we do it though? I don't have a calculator. Well, we can do it the Gauss way. Check this out. And also, it was given that, right? In the question, it says 0 plus 100 is 100. And if you pair up 1 and 99, that's another 100. And then if you do 2 plus 98, that's another 100. So I guess you can see we have 3 pairs and they add up to be 100. So far we have 300s. So now the question is, how many of these kind of 100s can we put together? Well, the next one will be 3 and 97 and so on, right? What's the last one? It's not 50 because 50 is by itself. So it's 49 and 51. This plus that also gives us 100. Now, how many of these 100s do we have? Well, it's not 49 because we started at 0. So in fact, we have a total of 50 of these 100s. So we have 50 times 100. But the answer is not 5,000 though, because remember, we still have the 50 in the middle. Aha. So we will have to add the 50 here. Altogether, this is 5,000 and then plus 50. So the answer is 50, 50. And this is a very classic question. And in fact, I wanted to take this opportunity to show you the general formula, the sum of the first n natural numbers. Now let's take a look. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus da 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 up to n. Firstly though, if you add the 0, it doesn't matter. And then n right here has to be a whole number. How can we figure out formula for this? Check this out. Since I want to know the result, we can call the result to be S for the sum, right? We'll add them up, right? Now, I'm going to write S again, but I'm going to do it backwards. So instead of starting at 1, I will start at n, and the next one is n minus 1, meaning just like 1 less than the first number here. And the next number is n minus 2, and so on, up to 1, right? So like an early example, it was 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way to 100. Then in this case would be 100, 99, 98, and so on, up to 1. Now we have these two equations. We are going to add them up. Now have a look. We have 1 plus n. Let me write it as n plus 1. And then 2 plus n minus 1. 2 and minus 1 is just plus 1. So this and that together is also n plus 1. And then the next one, same thing, right? 3 and minus 2 is plus 1, and we have the n, so it's n plus 1, and so on. And that will give us n plus 1 right here for the last one. So they all pair up very, very nicely. At the end here, though, we have s plus another s, so that's 2s. Now, on the left-hand side, how many of the n plus 1 do we have? Well, in this case, we have n of them, because you see, we started at 1 and all the way to n, right? So we have n pairs of these things, right? N pairs of them. So we have n times n plus 1, and that's equal to 2s. Now, I want to figure out what s is, because that's the sum that we want. We can just divide both sides by 2. So s is equal to n times n plus 1 over 2. And ladies and gentlemen, S is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus da 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 up to n, and that's equal to n times n plus 1 all over 2. And that is the formula. And now going back to the original question, n is equal to 100, and we will get 100 times 100 plus 1 all over 2. Work that out, you also get 50, 50, which is really cool.